Good evening. I thoroughly prepared for this in the last 5 minutes. So, there's a very well-known tale associated with Thor and his hammer, Mjolnir. The magical hammer that he wielded, and every time he struck lightning and thunder and so on and so forth. Thor never let the hammer leave his side. It had the strange property. Anytime he threw it, it'd come back to him, but only him. So he was very, very careful to keep a hold of it, because if somebody threw it away, it would be lost forever. One morning, he wakes up, slightly the worse for wear after a night of hard partying in Asgard style. The horn of mead had been passed around. He woke up. Where is it? He went hither and thither all over his hall, searching for Mjolnir. Couldn't find it anywhere. This could be a problem. Into the great hall he burst, waking up, kicking people left and right. Get out of bed, wake up, where is Mjolnir? I can't find it. I'm a bit lost without a hammer. Somebody please tell me you know where it is. Started looking around and he saw, sat at the back of the hall, trying very hard to mind his own business, a god by the name of Loki. Now Loki, some of you may know, was known for making a little bit of trouble. And he went up and he grabbed him and he went, Loki! Tell me what you've done with Mjolnir, please. I really need it back. I feel a bit naked without it. I really need it back. My lord, I don't know what you mean. It was right beside you when you went to sleep, but I was asleep as well, and I know nothing. Anyway, Loki, I know it was you. You better sort this out, or we're going to have problems. So there was Loki, sat in the corner of the hall. If I was Mjolnir, where would I be? It's a hammer, that's not his word. Who could possibly have stopped? Ooh. My lord king, I have an idea. I'll be right back. And off he set on the bridge from Asgard down to the world, and he rode through the world all the way down to the realm of the frost giants in Jotunheim. Really cold, miserable place. But the frost giants were always trying to fight their way up. And they always wanted to take Asgard, and the only way they ever could have was by claiming Mjolnir and striking Thor down. He walked into the hall. He went, my lord Thrym, the king of the frost giants. Big bloke, ugly, lots of teeth like gravestones sticking out. My lord Thrym, please don't eat me. I don't suppose you've seen Mjolnir, have you?
As a matter of fact, I have. Yes.
No? Excellent. Can we have it back?
What? No, you can't have it back. I'm coming to take Asgard.
No, you can't. You see, Thor really needs it for office work. He needs it back.
Very well. Tell Thor he can have it back if he gives me a bride in return.
Yeah, all right. Who do you desire, my lord?
Freya.
Okay. See what I can do. So off Loki went back to Asgard, back to Thor's hall. My lord Thor.
Ah, Loki, good!
Where's Mjolnir? Have you found it? Yes and no.
What, so you know where it is?
Yes.
Have you got it?
No.
Where is it?
Thrym has it.
What?
Thrym has it.
Thrym? What does he want?
Freya.
No!
You want Mjolnir back or not?
Yes.
Do you want him to marry Freya?
No!
Now, Freya, it has to be said, was a daughter of Thor's wife. Unparalleled beauty. Absolute hair of gold. Men wept looking at her. Beauty. Utter beauty.
And Thor was not about to let her go and marry this guy with teeth like gravestones. Really ugly. Oh, really, really ugly. No chance of that.
My lord, I have an idea.
Yes?
You're not going to like it.
Tell me, we need to get Mjolnir back.
How about you take Freya's wedding gown?
Yes?
And you put it on yourself.
What? I cannot dress as a woman
because, as Viking law was, one of the ways women could actually get a divorce in Viking law was if their husband was a cross-dresser. It's documented, you can actually check this.
So, of course, Thor wasn't really keen on this idea. He said, Loki, don't be bloody silly. I've got a big ginger beard, long hair, and... Well, I'm a man. I'm not wearing a dress.
Do you want Mjolnir back or not?
All right, give me the dress. And off he went.
Ice cream came out quite sheepishly. Looking a little bit like what you've seen the Michelin tire man, yeah?
A more muscly version, but shoehorned into a size 10 wedding gown, spilling over at all the seams.
Look at me. Yeah, you look lovely.
Oh, shut up, Loki! Not have you making a mockery of me.
Thought you're wearing a dress.
So what do we have to do?
So we'll get your chariot, and we'll ride down to Jotunheim, and we'll present you as Freya. To Thrym, and he's a giant, he's a bit thick. He'll believe it, as long as you don't utter a word.
I can do that.
And you behave like a woman.
What? At a wedding?
I said, yes, you know, eat little bits, drink little bits, behave yourself like a woman.
That's ridiculous, Loki.
Do you want Mjolnir back or not?
All right. So into the chariot they got, down they went to Jotunheim, and they arrived at the hall. Loki went up, bangs on the door.
Thrym! Got Freya! She's here, she's waiting for you. She's very excited. Oh yes, very excited.
Out came Thrym, and he looks at his bride-to-be. Veil down, all front, big bushy beard behind the veil. Not quite what I had in mind.
It's been a long journey. She could probably do with freshening up a bit. Maybe a glass of mead in private quarters.
Yes, okay. Go on then.
So in they went. Thor, remember. Well, only sip tiny, tiny glasses of mead. And don't eat too much.
But it's my wedding feast.
It's not your wedding feast. It's my daughter's wedding feast. Idiot, do you want Mjolnir back or not? Shall we do it then?
Okay. So out they shuffled onto the wedding dais, and he sat down. And in front of them was laid such a banquet as you've never seen, because frost giants are greedy. And in front of Thor was placed an entire wild boar roasted, and a barrel of mead. Straight away, Thor picked up the barrel of mead, knocked the top off, Loki sat next to him. Thrym on the other side looks at Loki and goes, Freya has an almighty appetite for mead.
My lord, it was a long journey. She was desperately thirsty. I'm sure her disposition will improve now, will it not, Freya?
Picks up the wild boar and gives it a spin. For anyone that's ever read an Asterix book or anything like that, much the same way as Obelix used to with the rolling of the boar, down to just the bones back on the plate. All the other frost giants, of course, think this is wonderful, for finally, Thrym has found himself a bride that has the same appetite for life as him.
Thrym's not so sure.
Looks at Loki. Loki, explain yourself.
My lord, she hasn't been able to eat with excitement for the last 7 days. Of course, she's ravaged by a terrible hunger.
Fair enough.
And so the evening progresses, with Thor getting more and more drunk and eating more and more and behaving less and less like a lady. until eventually Loki realises it's probably gone far enough. He says, "My Lord Thrym, is it not now time to complete the wedding ceremony and get your nuptials well and truly underway?"
Yeah. Bring her over here. Put it on his knee.
"My lord, is it not customary at this point to present the bride a gift?"
"Yes."
"Well, we did have an agreement, Freya for Mjolnir, so lay Mjolnir on her lap and we'll call it a deal."
Now, of course, out came Mjolnir, two frost giants staggering under the weight, laid it onto Freya's lap. Thrym sat there thinking his luck had come in. Beautiful wife. He's bound out, teeth don't matter. Lifts up the veil. Because, of course, underneath the veil are two baleful, burning eyes and a ruddy great big ginger beard. Staring at him with vengeance and death in his eyes. Wraps his hands around Mjolnir, stands up, and as he does so, bursts out of the wedding gallery like something out of a very low-budget Incredible Hulk Marvel comic thing, throwing white gown left and right. He swings the hammer over his head, and a giant strike brings down the pillars of the hall. "Look, I thought we should leave. Come on." And out they ran, jump back into the chariot, back over to Asgard. Thor walked back in. There he was, Mjolnir in hand, back on his throne.
"Loki,
you've done well."
"Thank you, my lord."
"Still thought it was you."
"Thought you might, my lord. However, I've done everything I can, and the frost giants won't be a problem anymore, will they?"
And that is how Thor rid the world of the frost giants once and for all.
Tell us about your working that's going to happen at the end of this year.
We were very, very careful when we picked the date so that we knew we wouldn't clash with a bit crack, because we do enjoy coming. So on the second Friday of every month, just in case you can't get enough of stories, up at Keel the Castle now, we are running an event called Weird Times in the North. You can find us on Facebook and all sorts of things like that. And it's going to be a collection of stories, folklore, hopefully when we can find some folk musicians. Folk musicians are really hard to find, by the way. There are hundreds of them, but as soon as you like try and get them to put their name on a piece of paper and book anything, they disappear like this. Very difficult to find. But every month there's sort of a loose theme on it, and it's from 7:30 until around about 10:30. There is a bar. And how much are tickets now?
They are, it is, it's £4 for adults and £2 for children.
There we go, four for adults and
what
two for children.
What can one look up electronically?
If you do Weird Times, spelt with a Y instead of an I, Weird Times, so W-Y-I-D, on Facebook, and also if you look on wildfire.co.uk, again with the Y instead of the I in wild,
Hyphened.
Weird thing I have with that one. you can find us on there.
Excellent. Thanks very much indeed.